The Diamond Sutra all around surrounds energy. Everything that we see around us is composed of the energy particles. Nothing else except energy stays. Energy exists. In our subtle form, we are nothing else but energy. The play, the movement of this energy in myriad forms becomes the way for transformation. When there is energy, energy needs intense fire. Intense fire for it to become fluid-like and then evaporate. Indeed, this is the only way for transformation to happen. First, energy has to be there. This energy requires intense fire, and the fire comes from passion. Passion is the seed whose fragrance is compassion. Passion is life. If you are doing anything without intensity, without fire, nothing will happen. Then your meditation will certainly lack energy. You have to create energy, and when energy begins to overflow inwards, the process of transformation begins. So passion lends the fire to that energy which surrounds you. Anything that exists around you, you can use that energy. Even a piece of stone that you see around you and you think it is an obstruction, you can use this as a device to climb over it. And you can reach to the other shore. Something that you had found as an obstruction in your way becomes the way. There is a beautiful story about Michelangelo. He is a sculpturist, a unique one, and I call him a Sufi. He used to spend his pastime at a shop. Just as when our day's work finish, we go to a nearby place, park or whatsoever place we choose, and spend our time there. So Michael used to spend time by the shop where he used to buy things of his need and spend time there. Because usually the people who are of creative instinct, they rarely have friends. Their own company is the only friend. So he used to spend time at the shop. At the back of the shop, there was a big piece of stone. Big piece of stone. The shopkeeper has no use for it. Michael used to watch it. Sometimes he will stand up a little closer, other times a little far, and used to look into. The shopkeeper always watched Michael looking at the stone with great fervor, with passion. He could not understand what is in that stone that Michael is looking at. One day, while the shopkeeper was to clean the place, he told Michael that there is a piece of stone, a big piece, it's a nuisance in the back. I want to get it disposed of. If you want, I can give it to you. This is what Michael wanted, but he didn't have the resources to pay for that stone. So he told, expressed his inability to pay for the stone to the shopkeeper. And in response, the shopkeeper said that I will give it to you. You do not have to pay for it. But there was another problem. Michael did not have the money to transport such a huge piece to his place. So shopkeeper agreed to transport it to the place of Michael. It was carried to Michelangelo's place. He started working with great fervor, with great intensity, great passion. And why he was so passionate about it? Because he had seen something invisible into that piece of stone. Something that nobody else could see it, but Michael had seen it. He wanted it to be known, expressed, so that others can see it also, the beauty that was hidden in the piece of stone. He started working. Time went on. Maybe something like that, and something of such a great magnitude is to take place, it takes time. Probably 2 years or 3 years passed. Michael completed. The passion of Michael completed the manifestation of that sculpture. You know what the sculpture was that? It was placed in the Basilica in Rome. It was a sculpture. Jesus' body is brought down from the cross and Jesus' head is resting on the lap of Mary. Jesus' head is resting on the lap of Mary. Beautiful sculpture. He covered it and called the shopkeeper. And he went and he told him that I want to show him something. The shopkeeper said, yes, you can show me. He said, no, for that you have to come to my place and I have to show you there. I have to show you there. Shopkeeper came. The stone, the carving, the sculpture was draped with a fine cloth. The shopkeeper wondered in astonishment, what is that hidden under that garb? His anxiety increased and he wanted to know, what is that Michael wanted to show him? With a little suspense, Michael removed the drape and the entire sculpture was shimmering in the moonlight. Tears began to flow from the eyes of the shopkeeper. He looked at it. He could not believe. Then he asked, how did you do that? He said, the sculpture, this particular piece of art was hidden in this tomb. There were many unwanted pieces of the material around it, many unwanted pieces of the stone which carry with them the energy in the subtle form. All I did removed all that was unwanted. When your energies are not focused, it is held to the skeleton, then the same energy begins to overflow and makes you tired, and you cannot attain to that which you need. The moment your energy becomes intensified, passion lends its fire, it attains new dimension. Without intensity, without fire, nothing will happen. Then your meditation will certainly lack energy, or for that matter, anything that you do will not have the energy. And when energy begins to overflow inwards, the process of transformation begins. If you are praying just as a formality, and love has arisen in your heart, then your prayer becomes meaningful. Your prayer becomes meaningless. It is absent. If you are praying to God and there is no passion, the fire, there will be no connection between you and God. You and the object that you are working on. Only passion can become the bridge, the thirst, the hunger. The more thirsty you are, the more is the possibility of inner connection. If you are utterly thirsty, or you have become a thirst, an embodiment of thirst, your whole being is consumed by your passion or energy. And then only something can happen. In that very moment, when your total intensity is there, or that moment of 100-degree passion, something indeed begins to happen. In that moment, when your total intensity is there, for that moment of 100-degree passion, something indeed happens. Therefore, never be lukewarm. People live a lukewarm life. They are neither this nor that. Hence, they remain mediocre. If you want to get beyond mediocrity, create a life of great passion, or intensity or energy overflowing, whatsoever you do, do it passionately, do it in more intensely. If you sing, sing passionately. If you love, love passionately. If you paint, then paint passionately. If you talk, then talk passionately with all the fire. Total energy indeed. If you listen, then listen passionately. If you meditate, then meditate passionately. Only then something will happen. And from everywhere you will start having contact with God. The inward journey begins wherever passion is. If you are painting with utter passion, your painting will become your meditation. There is no need for any other meditation. Dance with absolute passion so that the dancer disappears, only dance remains. It becomes a beauty, it becomes meditation. Then there is no need, nowhere to go. No yoga postures. This particular intensity becomes the yoga posture. The dancer has disappeared. The dance is there. It is pure energy, an energy vibrating or overflowing. It is in that state you connect to the unknown and unknowable, to that source of eternity within you. Why in that state do you connect? Remember when passion is total, ego vanishes. Ego can exist only in mediocre mind. Only mediocre people are egoistic, and really great ones are not egoistic. They cannot be, but their life has a totally different direction, a different dimension. It is the dimension of passion. Have you ever observed these two words, passion and compassion? Passion becomes transformed into compassion. The journey is a quantum leap from passion to compassion. But quantum leap happens only when you are boiling at 100 degrees Celsius. Then the water becomes vapors and disappears in the thin air. It is the same energy that exists as passion and one day becomes compassion. Compassion is not antagonistic to passion. It is passion blossomed. It is the fragrance of passion. The spring season for passion has come. I am all for passion. Do whatsoever you do, but be lost into it. Dissolve yourself into it, and this dissolution will become the way for salvation, the way for transformation.